I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make a mixed media card with fun ways to get texture and with fabric and distress oxide ink. I'm using Atonic Studios Media Die Set, and this is a great new die series that can cut lots of materials like chipboard and fabric, and I love that. I cut the shapes out of a chipboard, and I'm going to use a frame and a complete piece. And I start with adding pieces of fabric to the chipboard piece. I use collage medium that will work as a glue. You don't want to add it too thick to keep the texture. And I have to tell you that this video is a collaboration with Kim Dello. We are both sharing inspiration to use fabric on our projects. And Kim has an amazing channel, is a wonderful lady and a great teacher. So make sure to check out her video for more inspiration and don't forget to subscribe. I added the link to her video in the description box and in the end screen of this video. I also added the main products I used in the description box for you, and you can find the full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And when you do so, you may like to click the little notification bell so you don't miss a thing. After drying, I'm going to add a coat of gesso to make it ready for the next layer. I speeded up the video a bit, I'm really not that fast. And then I'm going to let it dry again, and this doesn't take very long. I'm going to cut the piece again with the same die to cut off the bits of fabric that are sticking out. I tape the die in place and run it through the machine again. I remove the bits that are still in the cut frame. And I glue them together with tacky glue. I use a sponge to add the glue to the complete back of the open frame. And I put an acrylic block on it to let it dry, and then I put it aside. I go on with the page, I add ink on my desk and I spray some water. Then I dip in the paper just some parts, I press here and there and keep the paper a bit curved, if that's a good word to describe it, so it just touches the ink in places. And then I use the heat tool to dry. And I blot the bigger drops of ink on the edges. And then I blot the complete page. And I do the same with the pink ink, dipping in parts of the paper and then blot. Now I spray some water with the distress sprayer, just squeeze it halfway to get drops to let the ink react, and then I use the heat tool to dry again. I use a frame I cut to mark on the page where I want it. And now I'm going to use masking tape to do some stamping. And you can use both sides. I use the non-stick side to get some lighter prints. Now this technique is similar to lots of fun techniques you will learn in my Stamping Without Stamps class, and that's all about mark making tools you can find everywhere to use on your craft projects, and I will add the link also in the description box if you want to know more. I just keep adding color around the marks I made and I use the frame to measure. Some more color along the sides of the page. So the frame is all dry and I'm going to color it with the green ink. I use a Nouveau brush and sprayed a bit of water next to the ink. I want it a bit darker, so I add the ink directly on the frame and then I use the brush to spread it. I use the heat tool to dry the ink, and then I'm going to do the same with the pink ink. And here you can see the fun texture of the fabric, and if you like it you can use a bigger piece of fabric and cut that with the media die too, of course. I'm using the collage medium again to add a layer, so this will add some texture too. And then I let that dry. I add some more green to the page to make sure the colors come together. The page is ready so far, so back to the frame again. I'm adding some more pink to get the bright color, just rubbing it on the frame to bring out the texture. and a bit of the abandoned coral. Here you can see the fun creases and texture. I add a layer of clear embossing powder to seal the ink and get some gloss. It will only stick to the parts of the frame where the wet ink is. Here you can see the fun layers and texture in the matte and gloss. So time to finish the page. I add some thread, which is a bit cheating fabric wise, but thread woven is fabric, right? So I add tape on both sides next to the marked line and I wind the thread around my fingers. And I peel it apart a bit and then I add it to the page. On with the frame again, I decided to add some black to lift the colors a bit. And I use a sponge to add the bits along the sides and my finger for the inside of the frame. And now it's time to assemble. I add the frame with a hot glue gun. Colored some ultra smooth card with the pink and green ink and cut some flowers and leaves. I crunch up the leaves a bit and just start adding them to the page. I just make a composition on the page, just piling my flowers up in the corner, mixing the big and small ones. And while you are here, have you seen the community tab at the top? Available on smartphone and desktop, and I will share new and fun things there like behind the scenes, sneak peeks, polls and such. So you can go check that out if you like. I add some gesso along the sides of the page. This helps the color pop a bit more. And to finish the flowers, I add pre-made Nouveau Crystal Drops for flower hearts, and I use the same color drops on a piece of paper, and I add a bit in the heart with a ball tool, and this will work as a glue, and this way you can reach the flowers better. Some more black drops on the page. And this is what it looks like after drying. Don't forget to hop on over to Kim's video to get more inspiration on using fabric on your projects. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting.